how to increase your chances of winning the bidding war in this very competitive seller's market here on Long Island. That's the topic of my next video. How to increase your chances of winning the bidding war here on Long Island. If you haven't read the newspaper or haven't seen the news, Long Island right now is in a very, very competitive seller's market. It's the perfect time to sell your property. All you need to do is list it and the buyers will come. Many of them, pre-approved buyers waiting to buy your property. And that's a wonderful thing. Interest rates, historically the lowest they've been in 50 years. Pre-approved buyers and very little inventory of people actually selling their homes right now leads to a great time to sell. But this particular video is about buying, how to win that bidding war. Recently, I attended an open house and people were waiting 2 hours to get in the door to see the property. Houses have been selling with multiple offers after only a couple of days of showing. This is the way it is on Long Island and in many other markets in rural communities, including the COVID scenario, which means a lot of people are migrating from the congested cities. So you add the fact that they not only are migrating out east, in this case on Long Island, but they are allowed to work either remotely full-time or remotely part-time, where they only have to commute a couple of days a week, and a lot of their kids are in school remotely as well, gives them freedom to move out to the suburbs. So with that being said, how do you win the bidding war as a buyer? Well, there's a couple of things you need to know. You need to have everything ready. You need to actually study how to do it and get your buyer package ready, so when you find that particular property, you're ready to move forward. The problem is a lot of buyers don't have the time to do that, nor do they have the experience, nor do they want to. So what's the answer? A buyer broker. A buyer broker relationship with your realtor is the best way for you to move forward. Have a trained professional working in your best interest. I'm going to give you four tips, four things you need to know about this buyer broker relationship. And hopefully by the end of this video, you will understand a little better why a buyer broker is the best thing for you right now to help you win the bidding war that's going on right here on Long Island. And with that being said, I want you to look at my particular website. My website actually offers a whole scenario of things, a whole bunch of free things for particular buyers and sellers. And naturally, if you go to the buyer link, you click virtual market analysis for buyers, and it takes you to a page where if you're looking for a certain area that you're considering buying, you should be proactive in doing your research now. You scroll down, you put in the actual home and the square footage, beds and bath, fill out all the other information. There's even a map part where you can check by a radius of a certain area, and you will get a push email of everything in that area that is going on the market, and it will tell you a little about that particular market. If you want a market watch report, you click the market watch report, and that will give you more valuable information, the statistics, average price, total listings, home for sale, recently sold properties, and the days they've been on the market, and so on. So go to my website, the link is down below, click on these particular things. If you're a seller, we also have a market watch for the seller, market virtual market analysis for the sellers, and these are all free to you to take advantage of because you are on my YouTube channel, and this is something I'm offering everybody, whether you're subscribing or not, but naturally I definitely would like you to subscribe so you can get all the new videos that come up. I usually post every week. And moving forward, the four things that you need to know about that will help you as a buyer, having a buyer broker relationship. One is confidentiality. If you go into an open house and you are talking to the agent there, they're representing the seller. They're not representing you, the buyer. Everything you say to them is being told to the seller or the owner of the house, and they're trying to secure the best price, the most money for that particular property. If you ask that agent, how much do you think I should offer on that house? They're going to tell you whatever it's listed for or more. And the reason is because, again, they're working for the owner of the house. If you found an agent by calling up through Zillow and they hooked you up with an agent, well, guess what? That agent is working for the seller of the home too, even if they've never met the seller. So if you ask that agent, how much should I market my house for? They're going to tell you list price or above, because that's what they have to tell you. If you have a buyer broker agreement, now you have an agent that's working in your best interest, and they're going to give you comps. They're not going to share their information with the seller of the home. They're not going to share it with the listing broker of the home either. They're working for your best interest. They'll tell you how long the house has been on the market. They'll give you current comps and tell you what other homes similar to that property have sold for very recently, if possible. And they're, again, they're working in your best interest. They are on your side. Number three, they'll negotiate in your best interest. They'll use their expertise to try to get you the best deal and get you that particular house, so they can, you can beat out the competition. And yes, there's plenty of competition out there. Lastly, number four, and this is probably one of the most important things, with the very limited inventory that's out there on the market, a buyer broker that has that signed contract with you has the ability to shop for sale by owners, to go out and represent you and weed out the for sale by owner homes that don't meet your criteria, but also find ones that do. And they could definitely take it a step further, which is something I do. And I'm proactive with all my buyer clients in that I go out and I actually scan neighborhoods where they would like to live and the houses that fit the criteria that they're looking for. And I'm proactive with mailings, without the COVID restrictions, phone calls, trying to find people that are thinking about selling but are afraid for whatever reason, or they don't want to put their house on the market now. But if I approach them, they don't have to deal with open houses. They don't have to deal with a lot of people in their homes. And I pretty much manage and facilitate the whole deal. And most of the time they get a significant discount, save a lot of money, because they're sometimes they don't have to list their property. So I hope this was helpful. My name is Mark Schreier, and I am a licensed sales associate with Century 21 American Homes. Again, don't forget to subscribe. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed the content, and I'll see you on the next video.